Everybody's talking at me. I don't hear words they're saying, only the echoes of my mind. People stop and stare.
This is Kugan Cassius for iFILM London with the Only Fools and Horses convention here in Peterborough. With me, I've got the oh-so-glamorous Sue Holderness. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. I'm good.
Do you remember me from last year?
I certainly do. How could you forget? How could I forget you?
Wow.
No, we're back again. And the thing that's so extraordinary is how many people have been here before and have done four, five, even six conventions. They know what it's like, and they still don't mind coming and queuing for 8 hours. So this show has got something special about it, hasn't it?
It has indeed. I mean, a few people have pointed out that the audience for it is getting younger and younger. So you've got children aged like 9 and 10 quoting from the series.
And you know why that is, don't you? It's because their barking mad parents have sat them down from the moment they emerge from the womb and said, this is what we watch on Friday, Saturday and Sunday. So they've sort of been forced to watch it. But the nice thing is that when they're forced to watch it, they do seem to think that it's entertaining and not dated. And kids like it as much as their parents did. Isn't it wonderful? I mean, it is amazing that Sullivan was able to do that, isn't it?
Absolutely wonderful. You might not know this, but on the last interview we done, people comment underneath, and you should look at them comments if you ever want to feel good about yourself.
Should I?
You
Why?
Should. What are they saying? Well, everyone's just like, because some people might not have seen you, even though you have been on stuff like the Green Grass and that, but it was very complimentary. Comments. You should have a look.
That's very nice. Now that I'm a senior citizen, I need all the help I can get. I like a few compliments.
40 isn't old, so.
if only that. No, I'm touring in Calendar Girls, so every night I and four of my fellow actresses, all of us senior citizens, have to remove all our clothes on stage. And it's a very nerve-wracking business, so it's jolly nice to be here and be able to keep my kit on.
Okay, I won't comment on that. So I'll just ask John Chalice about your relationship with Del Boy for all them years and that chemistry that you two had, but nothing really ever happened that we know of.
I used to get my bottom pinched. Do you think that would now be called naughty? Do you think that would not be allowed now?
Standard now.
It's sort of standard. Well, when the shows were going out and Del was always pinching Marlene's bottom, often I'd get my bum pinched in Tesco's and Waitrose. Don't think people would dare now. They'd think it was Jimmy Savile, wouldn't they? They'd say, you can't do that anymore. So I didn't mind it. I quite liked having my bottom pinched by Del. It was fun. But I must say, when strangers did it in the middle of an aisle in Tesco early in the morning, it did sometimes seem sort of slightly wrong. Do you know what I mean?
Did you ever say anything to them?
I was usually polite, but I did occasionally say, actually, we don't really know each other well enough for you to do that, sir. But usually I was reasonably nice and smiled and giggled and said, it's fine. But I'm quite glad that stopped, I must say.
Here's something you might not know. Do you know the episode where you and Boycey nearly have the baby from Del?
Yes.
Do you know that little black baby?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yes. Hello.
It's not you.
It's not. No, but it would have been funny, wouldn't it?
It would have been funny.
Really got you there. No,
we should find that baby.
That would be wonderful, wouldn't it?
How could we find that baby? That would be a coup.
I think Perry might
get
know.
Get the baby to the convention.
It's an idea. Perry, if you're watching this, Sue's just come up with a brilliant idea to find the baby.
I'd love to find that baby.
It's definitely not me anyway.
I did fall in love with that baby. It was a very adorable baby. I'd have adopted it if I could have.
His great grandfather was Louis Armstrong, that one.
Yeah. Yeah, and, you know, who wouldn't want that? Growing up with that. Louis Armstrong, well, that was one of the funniest speeches, wasn't it? His, I might be able to convince people you conceived and gave birth in 7 days flat, but how am I going to persuade him my granddad was Louis Armstrong? And it did bring the house down. But the clever thing in that episode was then Marlene had to say goodbye to the baby. And they had a very tender scene with Del. So having had this huge laugh, you then did hear the audience actually getting the hankies out and sniffing and crying. And that's what Sullivan could do so well. He could make his audiences laugh and he could make them cry. Weren't we lucky to be a part of it?
Wonderful. Just a quick word on, obviously, the late, great John Sullivan. What words can you... explain what he's left behind, the legacy.
He's changed my life. Without John Sullivan, my career would have been very different. And everything I do now really is because of Marlene. You know, I'm employed in Calendar Girls because of Marlene. I'm employed in pantomime because of Marlene. And I go on P&O cruises talking about Marlene. So John Sullivan was a very big force in my life. And he was also one of the nicest men that's ever lived. Not only the most gifted, but also one of the sweetest. A real family man. And I miss him terribly, but not half as much as his family must. And I mean, the nation must miss him. Everybody loved him, didn't they?
Of course they did. And just finally, what are you up to right now, apart from being at this convention?
Well, I was in Tunbridge Wells last night and drove back with no headlamp, which was rather scary. And I'm driving to Lowestoft tonight after this convention, where I'm doing my sixth week of a 10-week tour in Calendar Girls.
That's wonderful.
So if anybody out there wants to come to Lowestoft or Belfast or Dundee or Buxton or Wolverhampton, those dates remain. And then it's pantomime in Dunstable.
I know where Dunstable is. Near Luton, isn't it?
Near Luton. Snow White. I'm not playing Snow White. I'm the Wicked Queen, and I'm very scary.
Right, so Holderness, thank you very much for giving us your time. And until next year, let's see if we can actually find the little dark baby.
For the baby.
I'll speak to Perry. Let's see if we can make this happen.
Find him. That would be a coup.
He will.
Yeah. Find out what he's doing. He might be a mega superstar, and we just don't know.
How convinced were you that I was telling the truth then?
I was prepared to go along with it for about a nanosecond.
Actor, rather.
You should have kept it going, because I'd have been excited then. I might have adopted you.
You could do. You can still do that. I'm up for adoption if you're available as a mother.
You're prepared to tour around with me. It's quite a hectic tour.
I'm up for it. I'm up for it.
This is a new life for us both.
This is...
It's exciting, isn't it?
I know, it is a little bit. Let's turn that camera off a sec. Right, this is Kugan Cassius with wonderful Sue Holderness for iFILM London. Thank you very much.
Everybody's talking at me. I don't hear words they're saying. Only the echoes of my mind. People stop and stare at me.